Hello, ladies and gents, everything between without. Welcome back to more Heal the World of Warcraft, and we are starting up, of course, the LFR Blackrock Foundry. The first wing is, of course, the Slagworks. Now, this wing is well, it's pretty. I can say that, at least, you know. At least the slag works, as you can see down there, beautifully rendered. The giant ass furnace,
That's still recharging.
the melting pots. All right, and as you can see, I started off healing with casting my two beacons on the two tanks, because that I believe is the correct way to go about healing as a holy paladin in raids. And as you can see, I started just healing random people, either they were hurt or not, because, you know, each health, each piece of heals,
I can't
also
cast to that
gives
yet.
a part of it to the tanks. And unfortunately, the healers kind of dropped the ball here because two DPSs died. But, you know, could be their fault too for standing in crap. This part of the dungeon is raid. I mean, this part of the raid is pretty treacherous, because these small groundlings, or whatever the hell they are, basically they spew shit everywhere. And if you're not careful, you will take a lot of damage, especially if you're not
It's too far away.
Geared with balefuls like I was.
That
Many of
spell
these, who
is
knows,
great.
maybe were in the process of leveling up their gear by running LFR, or, you know, were in the process of obtaining their legendary rings, which, you know.
That's still recharging.
The ones who have a higher item level than usual are the ones who are looking for valor to upgrade their heroic or mythic gear, you know. Basically their raiding gear. That's the kind of people you find around here with higher than usual item
Need to get
levels.
closer.
Nowadays, at least. Used to be different back in the day. We actually had wipes then, but nowadays, almost none, you know? Basically, nowadays, with these high-level players, groups are just, you know, running through raids and not really giving a shit. And mythic raiding in Blackrock Foundry and Hymol, it's basically a 2-hour thing, I think.
I can't cast that
You
yet.
can actually clear
That
Hymol
spell isn't ready yet.
mythic nowadays in about 2 hours with good players and people who know tactics. And here we have the first boss. Called, who I don't know what the hell he's called. Oh, he's called Ore Gorger. Maybe because he gorges on ore, but that's assuming. You know what people say about assuming. I think you do, so I'm not going to repeat it. Okay, so basically this fight. And that's why you have to stay away from the puddles, of course. People up front, tanks, but also DPSs who constantly aim for the boss have to interrupt him when he casts, you know, spells which can be interrupted. And of course, be careful not to stand in crap. At some point during the raid, although I don't think is the case here, he will actually start rolling around and collecting ore in order to continue the fight, and in that phase you kind of have to dodge him. But in this case we were too fast and we actually stopped him in his tracks before he got to that phase. As you can see, he was already pretty much dead.
I need a target.
Indeed. As we speak, I did two of the four wings of Blackrock Foundry. Wait, are there four? I think there are four. And after that, I will do the five. Yeah, there are four. And after that, the five wings of Hellfire Citadel, and then this show will be over. And we can move on to other things. Next box is of course, Gruul. The legendary Gruul. Gruul the Dragon Slayer. Although on this Draenor he wasn't really a Dragon Slayer because dragons were not part of it. Basically what happened is that during the second invasion of the orcs, Nefarian decided to expand his influence in Outland, and so he sent one of his main guys there with a clutch of eggs. And things happened, and Gruul basically killed some eggs, killed a dragon, you know, and thus he was known as a Dragon Slayer. But of course, some drakes remained in Outland, and well, you know, died there. If you remember in Burning Crusade, the Blades Age Mountains or something like that, basically the whole area was a huge mountain of spikes, or you know, a mountain in the shape of spikes, on which dragons cured themselves, unfortunately. Black drakes, and remained all of these years there. Now here you have to be extra careful because these guys do massive AoE damage, and so you have to have your group heals in you know, unlock and use them pretty intensively in order to mitigate the damage as much as possible. And do not forget to holy shock your enemies or your friends in order to build up to store up energy for the Word of Glory. Well, actually no, the flame, yeah. Which, you know, you mainly cast on the tank, but you know, you can also cast on some melee or range, which for some reason are taking more damage than they should. Yeah. From what I remember of running Blackrock Foundry, one of the biggest pain in the ass were actually the mobs before the bosses. Okay, so fighting Gruul, you mainly want to stay away from his attacks. He has a few of them, as you can see. He does his little flame attack there, and he places a debuff on one half of the room, the half at which he's pointing, and then he does that thing which throws people in the air. You have to not stand in it, and then he does these little circles where the roof starts falling down, so you have to avoid those two. Basically it's an AoE fight coupled with group wide debuffs, And that's why mostly in this fight, as in the Butcher fight, the raid mainly tries to to split in two or more, no. Just to not get too many stacks. Although in the case of Gruul, I don't think that debuff comes in stacks. Yeah, see, no stacks, but it does last 30 seconds. So from time to time, you kind of want to cast a group heal. And yeah, remember to not stand and shit. Do not be like me, because right there I took 150k damage, which is not advisable in any situation, even if your health is 400k. Yeah, see, I wised up and moved out. And then Gruul was dead, and we were off to face the last boss right after we rezzed our unfortunate fallen. So the Gruul of Wars of Draenor was down, and the world lost an important addition to its destructive capabilities, for Gruul was indeed a force of nature, of perverted nature, but of nature nonetheless. As you can see, because the tank died, I had to recast the beacon on him.
Intruders are meddling with the blast furnace.
Oh, the blast furnace. You can imagine what a blast we were about to have in the blast furnace. Okay, for this ad, basically from time to time he will throw down a rock at someone, and shortly after that he will begin to cast a certain AoE spell. Now, in the olden days, when everybody had less health, the tactic was actually to go behind the rock and wait for the cast to die down, to end. But nowadays, when everybody has a shit ton of health, that's not really important anymore. Although, of course, I remember the old ways, and I decided to just go for it. But the others couldn't give less of a fuck. As you can see, this guy does AoE damage. He does all types of shit. So you kind of have to be careful, and also be mindful of the fact that that rock basically acts as a wall. So if there is anyone who stands opposed to you, you know, like if the rock stands between you and your target, then you won't be able to heal him.
Protect the furnace at all costs.
And then we had Forman Felspar to deal with, and. Okay, this fight could be a lot of fun. It has a few elements to it. Basically, you have to kill guys with bombs, or if you get bombs stuck to you, then you have to run to the blast furnaces to the left and to the right and place them there. Then you have to kill Forman Feldspar, and once the two blast furnaces are destroyed, that will summon the last boss. Basically, this whole fight is a giant ad fight with basically two mini bosses, Feldspar here, and then the blast furnace itself. So when the guys who have the bombs destroy those two, then the cauldron will heat up too much, and basically the entity who lives within it will emerge. And then the four shamans will try to keep it under control. You have to kill the four shamans and then kill the entity, and then you are home free. You've just completed the first wing of Blackrock Foundry on LFR. Be proud of yourselves. Not many people make it this far. Sarcasm. Alright. So as you can see, Feldspar was dead.
That spell isn't ready.
So as you can see, the engineers have a clutch of bombs stuck to their backs. You either kill them and pick them up, or you, actually, you know, if you get the bomb stuck on you, then you have to go and blow it up there. But when the engineers die, then someone can pick up a bomb and, you know, go for it. And of course, the engineer casts repair, which repairs those two things that you have to blow up, which is not ideal. So yeah. As you can see, the last entity appeared. Yeah, apparently it's called a Fury.
Get it under control.
Because,
my lord, we have it under control.
As you can see, you have Primal Elementus, aka Shamans, which you have to kill. Now, these Shamans keep the Fury under wraps. Once you kill the Shamies, then you can kill the Fury, and you're home free, as I've said before. And during this fight, basically, the tanks, I think, split. One goes to the left, one goes to the right. And, you know, healers have to go on the left and the right side. But I do believe that the side with less DPSs should have just one healer. Just because, you know, to try to keep it proportional. Usually the takedown of the Shamans is coordinated, but in this case, being LFR, you know, nobody really gave a shit, and just you know, attacked the nearest one to them. Nothing else to say, really. Pretty straightforward. Kill the Elementalists, and then kill the Fury, and then receive your rewards. And move on to the next LFR. Pretty damn straightforward.
Free. Warlord, we have
freedom.
Well, boo fucking who.
Freedom.
And this is the heart of the mountain. It's suffering from a severe heartburn.
Suffer.
And we have to put it out of its misery fast before he kills a soul. And my voice, for some reason, near the end is breaking down. Quite unfortunate, really.
Drown in fire.
You can't really drown in fire. You can drown in the ash of the fire, but not in fire itself, I'm pretty sure. again, stay away from puddles. Try to heal the guys with debuffs as much as possible, because of course they are most vulnerable here. But he was down, so I hope you've enjoyed, and I'll see you next time. Bye.